It gives me an immense pleasure to invite the chief guest and other dignitaries as they honor the dais. We have amidst us our esteemed chief guest of the day, Dr. Kiran Bedi, Honorable Lieutenant Governor, Government of Puducherry, the woman of action who has come here to shower us with the pearls of wisdom and knowledge. We are truly humbled by your presence, Madam. The honor is being honored by Professor Dr. Mishra, President, Institute of Town Planning.
It is also important to obtain the
Honorable Chief Guest of today's Valedictory session, Srimati Dr. Kiran Bedi, Honorable Lieutenant Governor, Government of Puducherry. Well, as to just give the brief of the Institute of Town Planners India, just for the information of the Honorable Chief Guest. Madam, the Institute of Town Planners India was established in the year 1951. At that time, there were hardly 10 town and county planners in the country, and majority of them, rather all of them, were educated abroad, because at that time there was no school of the planning and architecture in India.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, the professors, the academics, they are good in reflection, and the civil servants are good in action. But we have Honorable LG, who combines action with vision, action with reflection. And it's indeed a privilege and honor for me to address this distinguished gathering. And I must thank profusely and profoundly the Institute of Town Planners India, the Tamil Nadu Regional Chapter, Chennai. We're indeed grateful to you, sir, for organizing this Smart Cities Mission, Impact on Planning and Development of Cities, where our officers and civil servants have shared their experiences, which is going to be extremely useful.
Thank you, sir. Your speech serves as a testimony of how Smart City Mission is being successfully implemented. Thank you once again, sir. I take pleasure in inviting our Honorable Lieutenant Governor, Government of Puducherry, to deliver the Chief Guest Address. Welcome, ma'am.
Good evening, friends. I want to thank you for giving me the opportunity to be here for a very vital subject. Subject which is going to change the or improve the quality of life in the cities we live in. I've had a small experience with town and country planning. May I share you a story? 1993. Now that's not smart city, but it's smart building. Can I focus on smart building?
Yes,
ma'am. 1993, when I was IGP prisons in Delhi, Tihar jail, the Home Secretary called me and said, we have already been late in approving the new prisons buildings in Delhi. Therefore, the plan is waiting. Before me, there was a gap of three months. Nobody wanted to be IG prison. So there was a proposal which was pending. So they said, you have to come, now that you've come, clear the proposal. So I said, madam, she was a home secretary, was a lady. So I said, ma'am, let me see the proposal, what it looks like. While I looked at the proposal, I had already been about 2 months or 1.5 months as IG prison. And within few days, we had started a few programs which were adding to the day schedule of the prisoners. We had started programs which needed space. So we were looking at nooks and corners of the prison. Where do we do them? For instance, we had introduced yoga. We didn't know where to go. We introduced schools, education. We didn't have a classroom. I wanted them to eat together, we didn't have the dining halls. Wanted them to play in the evening, we didn't have it. But we had some places we didn't even have had an open space staged in such a way that they could listen to a spiritual discourse. Some prisons had, some didn't. So while these programs were already on way, and we also had prisoners' children inside the prison, who didn't have anything. They were all lodged within with their mothers through the day. They were locked up with their mothers. They didn't have any school, nothing. So there was no play-based school inside the prison. So what happened was that within those few weeks, we didn't lose time. What was required for that humanity of 10,000 prisoners? It was a township. So it was a town of a municipality of 10,000 people. And we were looking for where do we do this? But we didn't find spaces. Wanted to start a vocational school. We didn't have a building by which we could put them into computer training programs. So, but this proposal of the Home Secretary was being pressed to clear. When I looked at the proposal and I looked at what we were doing, if I would clear the proposal, it would repeat what is the building which is existing. And I was under pressure to say, you clear it. My common sense said that whatever I clear now is going to last 100 years minimum till it's rebuilt, etc. So what am I clearing? Why should I clear? No, you have to clear. I was called by the Union Home Secretary at that time and said, no, we don't have time. I said, sir, I cannot clear this because it's not meeting my needs. My needs are the following, and these needs are not being met. What do I do? He said, he tried to understand what I was saying. I said, if I clear it, it will hurt my conscience for the rest of my life that I cleared something which is not meeting the needs now and for the future. He said, how much time do you want? I said, you give me whatever time, minimum you can, but I will have to get it readdressed. He said, okay, I'll give you about a month's time. Then the School of Architecture and Planning, which was on the right side of our police headquarters building in Delhi, I knew them. There was Mr. Bose there, Director Mr. Bose. Mr. Ghosh, somebody, Begoli. Yes. And they called me for some event, so I had happened to go across. I met them and I connected with them. I said, can you? Now look, you have a fee. I have to go through a tendering process when I engage you for services. I said, but I wanted pro bono. I don't have time. Pro bono, I need. Please look at my map. I can't clear it and I have a month, but I have to save the situation. He was so kind. He came with his team to Tehar. That's the when your planning started. Then he asked me the right questions. What are your needs? What is the purpose? Who are the occupants? All the right questions which you do in your town planning. I gave him that and then I showed him, look, I'm without any infrastructure for all these activities. How do I meet them? In the new building also, that means we'll never have reform system in this township. So where are my reforms programs? He read through the planning, completely friends. I'm happy to announce that plan was approved, which was cleared by School of Architecture and Planning. That's the new building. Old prisons remain the British buildings. What I'm trying to explain to you, what I'm trying to say is, the easy way out with many of our planners is to cut and paste. Copy, paste. They don't go back every individual. Puducherry is different from Chennai. Puducherry curriculum may be different from here. Everybody has their own city culture and the needs. Some needs are absolutely common, like your security is common, school need for common, police station is common, senior citizens need is common, safe walking is common. Safe traffic management is common. Cleanliness is important. Water harvesting is important. Waste management is important. These are all common facilities. But there are other needs. That's why I think the concept of CBD came, where you had a composite area where you had the basic essentials. You need not go travel far enough beyond a particular diameter of kilometers and you get the facilities. That's why CBD started to come. I was recently in Chandigarh. I saw a very interesting failure of. On one hand, it's got fantastic roads, networks planned. But on the other hand, I see all hostels, balconies towards the road, and nothing but all cloth lining. Everybody's pants, shirts, all undergarments, all visible from the road. Why should you make a place in such a way that that all these undergarments, etc., are visible from the book. Create a situation in such a way that this doesn't hang around here. Otherwise, the whole scene of my, because I'm a student of Pidar, I loved Tamil. But when I saw it, it was, who did not think, while you thought about the way the buildings would look like, typically the European way, London complex way, all look alike. So all sectors, particular sectors look alike, a particular market looks alike. Now there's a reason for or against it. But when you have hostels like this, and if you have cloth, create a situation where cloth lining will only, that means probably you cannot have a balcony towards the roadside. Balcony should be on the other side, which looks it. I don't have the answer. But we need to find the answer. What should the road look like when you look at the building? Should it all be hanging with clothes? The whole scene of the situation changes. So these are my few stories which I wanted to share with you. Then I know when I was in Delhi, and then Mr. Jagmohan was the lieutenant governor. Rohini, Pitampura, Saraswati Vihar, all that area, those people who Delhiites, was all flat land. All flat land. And I remember the whole township of Rohini came up. Then we start to look for police station kahan khole, school kahan khole, dispensary kahan kare. There was no space left for a police station. No space left for a fire brigade. No space left for a hospital. Then you start to cobble things around. So what's wrong with our training? Maybe what you rightly said, where are we being trained? Why don't we look at basic needs of the township which we are creating? Let me talk about Dwarka. Dwarka is, I don't know how many floors, 10 floors, Dwarka township. Have you seen it?
Yes.
You cannot live in that. Because every second minute or a third minute, there's an airplane which makes a noise. Even if you keep your doors shut, the noise of the aircraft, it pierces through your houses. Anything you're talking, you say, wait. Upar se plane ja raha hai. You're talking, you say, plane, wait. And then zip auto. Then you say, wait, then another plane. And the kind of frequency we have got in the planes now, I don't know how people are living there. Look at the kind of sound pollution and sound harassment these people are facing, but they're living there. Because it's constructed. At that time, I think we should have factored in that what are the, if there's a sound, this is not to be clear. It's a sound polluting place. I do remember having been there, I made a mistake of buying a house there. I never went and lived there. I rented it out. And recently I've sold it. Because I couldn't take that noise pollution. And yet it was bought and it was sold and people were willing to occupy. This is bad quality of life. So therefore, when we do these smart, there's another serious matter which before I tell you. Because I'm not an expert in this field. I'm only giving you my practical sufferings which I've seen myself. And the answers also lie with you. Is the sequence when you do a town planning, or you do a planning, or a smart city, what is the sequence? You also dig pavements, you also dig this, you do ATM, you do this. Where's the sequence? Where should you spend your money first? And what can go parallel? I think we need a sequence. I noticed in my smart city project in Puducherry, before any essential thing was done, all my pavements were dug up. And I said, why are you picking up? Pavement is a part of project of smart city. I said, where are smart city? Pani to mujhe de do, bijli to andar kar do. But smart city, then no sequence. So when we do a planning, Mahesh, I think, and Arjun, both of you, we'll have to work on a sequence. Money is limited. And when money is limited, you have to be very, very careful in its execution. Every penny counts, and you need to have a sequence. What must come first, and what same digging can take care of the optic wire, or it can take the bijli wire, or the telephone wire, and power wire, so that you don't dig four times. And then after the digging is over, who takes care of safety? It's all about execution. As town planners, give the executives a town a sequence which should only follow, so that three times digging and people don't sprain their ankles walking on those footpaths or even on the roadside. And what about the contractors? Who trains these contractors who leave all the sand and the budgery on the road? Don't you have a contractors association? You are the ones who are the biggest employers of contractors. Should you not be training contractors? I want to ask you. Should you not be training contractors who actually build? They are actually ruining some of the things you do. You need to associate contractors. You need to have a contract. Do you have a contractor contracting academies? Do we have contracting academies? Do we? Kavido? It's like having training in the IPS and not training constables. How can you, that's your, these are your foot soldiers really. How do they, what is the kind of contract? They buy unemployed labor, aur usko sochte hain usko sab kuch aata hai, wo sari budget, and the truck driver leaves the sand, right? Why? Because you are constructing that building. Friends, we'll have to stretch a little beyond our responsibilities and see what's affecting us around the area and work through. Now, I understand you need sensitive bureaucrats. You do need sensitive civil servants. Everybody's not equally sensitive. Some are sensitive and some are not sensitive. I understand this. But you are also in power. You have to exercise collective power. You may not be individually in power, but you must use the power of coming together, of associations. And you may have to take sometimes the civil service, the civil court route. I know it's tough. It's very harassing. It's also very time consuming, my friends. It's also frustrating. But we owe a responsibility. If we not, then who? We must never give up to correct the matters. So I would think these are some of the things I have in mind. Rest, you're the expert. But all your town planning, whatever you build, must have sunlight, must have natural light, must have eco-friendly material, must have safety for senior citizens, must have normal security. How do you secure security? Must be cost-effective, must have space, must have waste management, must have waste water harvesting, must be self-reliant, must be culturally sensitive, and no copy-paste. This is what I just scribbled down as you triggered my thinking. I'm sorry to see that my CEO of Smart City is not here. I quickly found out from Mahesh where is Arjun, and Arjun sent me a message, he's down in fever. That is the reason he's not here. Otherwise, he's a nice, young, sensitive man. Is anybody here from our team? Anybody here from our team of this? No, you're not in my this thing. Are you part of the board? You're part of the Smart City Board.
PSCDL.
But where are the bureaucrats?
I'm the French expert of PSCDL.
I know that. Where are my bureaucrats?
Smart City.
Smart City bureaucrats. They're not here. Whereas they should have been here. Even the second in command came here, should have stayed back. I'll find out why did he leave. Why did he leave? Was he here through the day? Or did he come to speak and go? Did he speak and go? I'll find out why. He should have spent the whole day with you and not spoken and gone. He should have stayed back. So anyway, this is what's happening with our civil services. I think they're getting insensitive and probably they think speak and go, we don't need anything to learn. The sensitization will not happen. I'll do whatever correction I can. But friends, this is my limited learning of my administrative experience. All I can say is, we are still in power. We have the power of collective will. We must create networks. We must continue to sensitize whatever we can. I don't have all the answers, but I'm groping for answers myself. Groping for answers, we keep getting solutions. And we are succeeding. It's not that we are not succeeding. We are succeeding from nothing to plenty, and plenty more to do. But if we had not galvanized ourselves, taken on the challenges, desperately done things differently, we would have been actually on the decline. Even this morning, you know what, you town planners, how much do you go on the ground, on the field? How much do you all go on the field to check things for your implementation? How much do you do? How much do you do? I'm asking you. You two have become bureaucrats. You also don't go on the field because you don't want to spoil your shoes having dust. You also don't go on the ground. Tumne naksha ek bari, you give it a map and that's yours. You don't go and see it's going wrong or right. Do you?
Yes,
you go. How many times? How many times?
Most of the time.
Good. How many of you most of the time? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, many sitting here. Unless you get out every as often, you have only field work. Your work is field. Your work is not at home. Your work is to build others' homes and other townships. How can you be sitting at home? Go and see what's happening. Go and say, this is not what we said. It's going wrong. Do you report defective structures which are coming because you've seen it just in time? And you say, that's not my job. It's the job of my client. It's called distancing and indifference. And indifference. Friends, the secret is not distancing and indifference. The secret is staying on the ball, remaining conscientious, remaining committed, feeling a sense of responsibility, having an sense of ownership. It's a sense of extra mile. That's called the extra mile of life. Nothing is achieved in this world without the extra mile in your life. And that extra mile is that which is pinches you a little, which takes you out of your comfort zones. You are not field planners. You're not office planners. Even the field drawing can be best done on the ground. But after drawing, stay connected with your clients. Stay engaged with them. And not they are also sitting in the office. You are also sitting in the office. That is why all the bajri, the kinkar is all on the road and the two-wheeler going on it loses his head and dies in a fatal accident. It's leading to that. And you don't worry about the contractors. You don't connect with the contractors. You don't pull them up. You don't find a way to train them. Also co-opt them. In fact, town and country planning should have a training wing for the contractors. If you want to do something different. So thank you so much. Jitna bulaoge, utna aur sunoge. Suna? Suna? Kafi. That's enough today. Thank you very much.